Hello friends, so today we are going to see and learn interesting maths activity using these two postcards. So even if you don't have any postcards, you can use similar cutouts from a card sheet. As you can see, these postcards, back in the day, people used to send messages to one another using them. But today, we are going to learn a very interesting maths activity through them. If I ask you what is the shape of these two postcards, you'll say they are rectangular, which is perfect. So let's measure the length and breadth of these two postcards using scale. So as you can see, the length is 14.5 and breadth is 9.5. And then how do we get the area? Area is just the product of length and breadth for any rectangle. So for this, area is product of 14.5 and 9.5 centimeters. So the product is 137.75 centimeter square. So now we have two identical postcards with perfectly same surface area. Now I'm going to fold these two postcards, one along the length, so like this, and the other one along the breadth. Like this. So here, with the folded ones, we now have two cylinders. We are going to stick them using the tape so that one will be fat and short and the other one will be tall and thin. We are going to mark A as the fat cylinder and B as the tall cylinder, just for our convenience. Here are the two cylinders, A and B, fat cylinder, thin cylinder. Now I'm interested in filling these two cylinders with some material. And my question is, which cylinder do you think will hold more of the material? In the language of mathematics, which cylinder will have greater volume? So you have three options. Either it will be cylinder A, cylinder B, or both will have same volume. So most of the people will say, as they have same surface area, they must have same volume. Let's test this with actually filling this with some material. Here are our two cylinders A and B, and this is the material required. We are going to fill cylinder A first with the material. Fill it completely up to the upper edge. And cylinder B also with the same material. So here are the two cylinders which are completely filled until the upper brim. Now gently remove the cylinders to get the pile in the plate. This also. So what do you see? The amount in cylinder A seems to be higher than the amount in the cylinder B. Let's confirm whatever we have observed. For that, we have placed fat cylinder A in the plate and we are going to place thin cylinder B inside the fat one. With the same material, we are again going to fill only the thin cylinder till its upper edge. Now that this is completely filled, I'm going to remove it slowly. And you can see there is still space remaining in the fat cylinder. It is almost 2/3 filled. This confirms that the fat cylinder A has bigger volume than the thin cylinder B despite their same surface area. Let's measure the actual volume of cylinders by using mathematical formula. So, as we know, the surface area for both the cylinders was the same, which is the product of length and breadth. (14.5 cm × 9.5 cm). This gives me the surface area 137.75 cm². Now to get the volume of cylinder A, volume of the fat and short cylinder. The formula to get the volume of any cylinder is pi r square into h. So pi r square is the area for the base circle and h is the height of that cylinder. Here we are going to take value of pi as 3.142 to 3 decimal places. Now to find r square, we first need to find r. So let's measure it. For cylinder A, this is 4.6, which is the diameter. So radius is half of it, which is 2.3 cm. So 2.3 cm, and we are going to square it into. The height for the fat cylinder is 9.5 cm. Ultimately, we get the product equal to 157.90 cm³. So this is the volume for the fat and short cylinder A. Now, similarly, we are going to find volume of the tall and thin cylinder B. Volume of cylinder B. Again, the formula remains the same. Pi r square h, and the value of pi is here also up to 3 decimal places, 3.142. Again, we are going to measure the radius for tall cylinder. Let's measure it. So the diameter is 3, means the radius is half of it, which is 1.5 cm, and we are going to square it into. The height for the tall cylinder is 14.5 cm. And this gives me product equal to 102.5 cm³. And now this mathematically confirms that volume of fat and short cylinder is actually bigger, and it is almost 1.5 times the volume of tall cylinder. So this happens because the volume of cylinder is directly proportional to the square of the radius. So directly proportional means as you increase the radius, the volume is also going to increase along with its square. So here the radius is more than here, so this volume is bigger. In our day-to-day life, there are many objects that are cylindrical in shape. In the kitchen, there are cylindrical containers. For storage of water, there are water tanks. They are also cylindrical in shape. So what they do is, for the given surface area, they try to maximize the volume And to do this, we increase the area of the circle instead of increasing the height of the cylinder. So if you have observed, the ones which are with storage capacity more are always fat cylinders. I hope you enjoyed this activity and learned something new with a new approach. So for more such fun with hands-on science and math activities, please visit YouTube channel IISER Pune Science Activity Center. Have fun!